Are you a content creator who likes to edit videos on the go? Especially now because the borders and schools are opening back up, but are sick of having to buy super aggressive looking gamer laptops just to get the job done? Hi, it's already 2021. Get with the times, boomer. There are now more options for you to carry around if you're not fans of the fruit brand. Today I'm going to talk about everything you need to know when choosing a laptop for content creation, aka photo and video editing, aka making it rain YouTube dollars. Your mother no teach? I teach you lah. Disclaimer, this video is sponsored by MSI, who has kindly sent over this MSI Creator Z16 laptop for demonstration purposes. Everything that I'll be mentioning will still be relevant no matter which laptop you end up with, but if you're interested to pick one of these babies up, feel free to check out the links in the description. Okay, when it comes to choosing a laptop as a content creator, there are two main things that you need to pay attention to: the outside and the inside. Chey, of course the outside and the inside lah, abu den. But it's true, there are certain external features and internal specifications that can make or break a laptop for content creators because of our very specific needs. Without further ado, let's jump right in. People say that you shouldn't judge a book by its cover, but do you know what you can judge by its cover? A laptop! Here are the main factors that really matter. Number one, we have good build quality. Now, a content creator's laptop needs to be able to survive being moved around a lot and also brush off the occasional bumps and drops. For instance, this Z16 comes with a CNC aluminum body, so it has less points of failure where materials usually meet around the seams of maybe like the keyboard deck. The rigidity of the construction is also very important, especially for larger laptops. You want minimal flex throughout the entire body, like this. Another important part that you have to check for is how robust the hinge is. Unlike a laptop that is just going to sit on your desk all the time, if you're a traveling content creator, you're going to be opening and shutting that hinge a whole lot more. There are also other factors like weather and temperature resistance, such as the MIL standard 810G military standard that came with this Z16 laptop. Now, unless you're taking this laptop hiking, ruggedness is not really that crucial, but your laptop should still be able to handle working under the hot sun in the park or by the beach, or even dealing with more humid weather conditions in the jungle. If you like to go into the jungle to look at birds, orangutan, you can do that with a laptop like this. Tough eh, see? Number two, portability. Now we all know that with great power comes great weight. And that is definitely true. Nobody wants to lug around a desktop replacement laptop weighing 3+ kilograms when they are editing videos on the go. Also, the overall size of the laptop can determine the size of the bag you need to carry to lug it around. In my opinion, for on-the-go photo editing, 13 to 14 inches would be great. But if you want to do any sort of video editing, especially 4K content, 15 to 16 inches is more appropriate, just like this 16-inch Z16 that is 359mm by 256mm and 15.9mm thick. It is not too bulky and should fit in just fine with a medium-sized backpack or any decent-sized messenger bag. Also, another thing that could add to the bulk is the power adapter. Something like this 180 watt slim adapter would be great. Number three, we have the screen or display. The number one key feature that a screen on a content creator's laptop needs to have is good color accuracy. Because with good color accuracy, you're gonna have a more accurate reference when editing or color grading. Contrary to what a lot of you might think, sRGB coverage is not really the standard for video content. DCI P3 is a wider color space and is most commonly used in digital movie projection. Another thing that we need to look at is the color difference measured in delta E, the average delta E anyways. For creative work, we need to have an average delta E that is less than 2 or equals to 2, so that the color difference is imperceivable to the human eye. This Creator Z16 from MSI has an advertised DCI P3 coverage of 100% and a factory calibrated delta E average of less than 2. That should be great for most video work as long as the laptop can handle it. After that, we need to take a look at resolution, which I think should be tied to pixel density. A 16-inch laptop like this with 2560 pixels by 1600 pixels would give us a pixel density of 188.68 ppi or pixel per inch. That is higher than a 27-inch 4K screen, more than enough for most types of work. And if you want a larger screen, you can always use an external monitor when you're plugged in. The Z16 with Thunderbolt 4 ports can support up to two 4K 60Hz screens or one 8K 60Hz screen. Number 4, we have keyboard and touchpad. Having a good keyboard is very important for content creators like me because we write our scripts a lot on our laptops. Now, a keyboard like this that is quite tactile and nice to type with is very good because you won't run into finger fatigue over long sessions of, you know, typing. Also, while I don't personally do it myself, some people edit photos and videos with their touchpad. And also, like it or not, not having to bring a separate mouse does make your portable setup a little less cumbersome. It needs to be a decent size with accurate tracking and feels smooth to use. Now let's dive a little deeper and talk about the inside, the guts of a content creator's laptop. Number 1, we have the CPU or the processor. Now depending on which editing software you use, some could be more CPU dependent like Adobe Premiere Pro. Something like the i7-11800H in our Z16 laptop is a good example of a powerful laptop processor. If you want to find out more about this, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel because when we do laptop or GPU or CPU reviews, we often do content creator software tests to see if they are more CPU dependent or GPU dependent. Number 2 is of course the GPU. Now a discrete GPU in a laptop is very important if you use DaVinci Resolve or After Effects because of the higher GPU utilization in GPU accelerated effects. Some Premiere Pro effects are also GPU accelerated, so that might also help. Hardware and coding during render will also utilize the GPU. Also, if you're a streamer, having a laptop like the Z16 with an RTX 3060 will give you a few benefits such as GPU encoding for live streams using NVENC, and also things such as NVIDIA broadcast that comes with a whole load of features that might be useful for you. The rule of thumb for a laptop for content creators is that having a discrete GPU is kinda necessary. Number 3, we have RAM. From my personal experience, when editing videos, if you want the smoothest time while scrubbing through footage and even dealing with a few layers of effects and transitions, the rule of thumb is you need to have at least 16GB of RAM for 1080p video editing and at least 32GB of RAM for 4K video editing. Laptops like this Z16 sometimes offer multiple models with various RAM configurations, so you should choose wisely based on your workloads. Also, some laptops might offer upgradable RAM slots where the memory is not actually soldered, so that's a plus. Number 4, we need fast storage. Now depending on the footage you're working with, the read-write speed of your storage is very crucial. People often say that internal storage is faster, because in most cases, that is very true. Take this Z16 for instance, what we have is an internal PCIe NVMe storage that has a transfer speed of 2000 megabytes write and 2000 megabytes read, because it is a PCIe Gen 4 SSD. This is important because video footage from cameras can be quite demanding to work with. For instance, if you're using a mirrorless camera like our Sony a7S III, the most demanding recording format has a data rate of 600 megabits per second or about 75 megabytes per second. That might seem very small compared to the 2000 megabytes per second that you can get with the internal storage, but if you add a few layers of footage on top of each other, as well as effects and stuff like that, it gets pretty heavy quite quickly. Not to mention, if you're using more serious cameras, the data rate can go a lot higher. So having fast storage is very important. If you have a laptop like the Z16 here with Thunderbolt 4 ports and the right external drive, you're gonna get comparable performance as the internal storage. Which brings us to the next point. Number 5, good connectivity. Now, we all know that content creators gotta have their toys to help them work more efficiently, especially if they are not on the move. Say you're at home or in a work setting in your studio. You might want to add an external display or two, a mouse, a keyboard, a Blackmagic micro panel for color grading, or if you're old school like my editor Azrai, a Wacom tablet, which I will never understand. Anyways, if you're adding so many things, you'll find yourself running out of ports very quickly. And this is where Thunderbolt comes in. A Thunderbolt 4 port has a massive maximum throughput of 40 gigabits per second or 5 gigabytes per second and can utilize a dock or Thunderbolt monitor to further expand your connectivity options. The Creator Z16 has not just one but two Thunderbolt 4 ports as well as two regular USB ports. That should be enough for everything you need, including plugging in external monitors as well as a Samsung portable SSD X5 with a maximum transfer speed of 2800 megabytes per second read and 2300 megabytes per second write, which is actually faster than the internal storage here. Oh yeah, before I forget, because a lot of us content creators like to use our fancy studio monitor headphones, having an audio jack is actually quite important. Number 6, we have battery life. Now this is somewhat of a bonus feature because most laptops do perform better when plugged in, especially for heavier content creation workloads like ours. However, if you want to edit videos on the go, maybe for a quick social media post or a simple edit, or if you're someone who needs to manage your social media accounts and emails for clients, then you might want to concern yourself with battery life. Take this Z16 for instance. With a 90 watt hour battery, it lasted us about 6 to 7 hours on normal use at medium brightness, which should be fine for most use cases. On to the bonus features, and the first one would actually be the webcam. Having a decent webcam is actually pretty useful so you can go live wherever you are. It is also quite useful for meeting up with other content creators or even your clients for con calls and meetings. The next bonus feature is of course the SD card reader, and what we have here with the Z16 is actually a micro SD card reader. Now, I don't really use SD card readers from laptops much because they're usually of a slower speed. I usually use an external SD card reader that has a UHS 2 speed support, especially when I'm using cameras like the Sony A7S III or the Canon R5, because those cameras use SD cards that have ratings up to V90. So make sure that you find out what kind of SD card your camera is using before buying your SD card reader. And that is everything you need to know about picking a laptop as a content creator. Thanks again to MSI for sponsoring this video and sending over this Z16 as a demonstration sample. Now, I personally think that the Creator Z16 is quite a lovely laptop for content creators that is almost perfect in every way. We have a color accurate display, a solid build quality that is not too heavy, a nice keyboard, trackpad, and also a good amount of I/O ports. Except for that micro SD card reader. Dear MSI, not everybody who shoots videos use a GoPro, okay? So please give us a full-size UHS 2 SD card reader next. That's all folks, leave a comment down below if you have any questions regarding this laptop or content creator laptops in general. Also don't forget to like and share if you thought this video is awesome, and subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more content like this. And I will see you, when? In the next one!